Tonight is opening night. This is the night that we are waiting for. The star is the mod.
For a while, right?
I don't know where it came from. It just came out of nowhere. Let's go, guys. Bring it in for the prayer. Let's go.
Dear Lord, thank you for blessing us with this bond that we've created. I just want to ask for the strength so we can just perform on stage, do ourselves proud, and do everybody else proud. And I just want to say thank you for the people and the love that you have given us. And may we just do everything that we can and just leave all of our hearts on the stage. Mm-hmm. And may you bless us for the whole week and just keep the spirits of the people that we've lost shining over us. Amen. And in their name and in your name we pray, Lord. Amen.
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 FlexN Manchester.
3, 2, 1.
FlexN!
I've always felt it and I've always been so passionate about dance and everything, but after this, I am confident to call myself a dancer.
One word, really, just one.
You can't describe FlexN in one word.
FlexN doesn't have rules. We don't have things that we have to follow.
When I'm dancing, I don't think. I just go.
I think it's really about character. When you have a character when you dance, or when you have a presence, it's gonna be different from everyone else.
I look at FlexN like a lifestyle. Yeah. I wake up, I'm in the mirror, I'm brushing my teeth, I'm like this. Yeah.
It's really like, you know what? What are you feeling at the moment? Where do you want to go? What is your other personality? What character do you want to portray? Like, these are the different things that we think about while we're dancing. The show that's put together on this stage right here was pretty much about some of the lives of the dancers. It's about some of the things that we had over at the Park Avenue Armory was some political issues going on. It was racism that's going on in America at the moment and pretty much all over the world. We just really just want to develop a piece that speaks to everyone, that speaks to people.
Like, you don't understand how big this has been, like, for me personally. Like, it's so much more than just a show as well. Like, it's them as people, like, what they've shown me and, like, the way they think and the way they, like, see the world and what they've been through and some of the stuff they've shared with us.
MIF put out an audition through their website and through like some of the media. And then some people responded. We picked the ones that sent in the videos. We just went by feeling and faith. So, like, some people were like, in their video interview, they were like, were extremely, extremely good and said, hey, those are easy picks. But then some of them, we had to just see in person. And then so we got to Manchester and we got a chance to see these dancers in person. They skyrocketed. You know, so we just made that decision. We all sat down together and said, hey, who are we going to use? It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy. Because it was a lot of good talent there. So it was another great experience. And then I said, okay, you know what? Hey, you guys are really good at this. You guys are good at this. You guys are good at that. Let's put it together and make a great show.
10 of us from New York, 10 of us from Manchester. And we aim to kind of do the transatlantic collaboration.
The very fact that the process, in my head, I was like, oh, we're going to walk into this and they're going to be like, right, we're doing this, we're doing this, we're doing this. But instead, day one, it was like, okay, what can you bring? Yeah. And that was the very first thing. Like, have you got a piece? Have you got like a topic, a social topic or anything like that?
Going through this process, we had to really do a lot of homework, let's say. And I mean homework meaning like dancers had to actually go home and think about certain ways that made them feel a certain way. You know, certain things, like say for instance, think of a moment that changed your life.
Reggie was like a puzzle solver. You know what I mean? He put all the puzzles together, but we had a lot of influence in the show. Like we, our solos and our stories actually came from the heart. Like it was genuinely something to do with us and how we felt.
He's used everyone's stories to interlink to make one big narrative that all links together, but it still stays true to each person's story.
When we started doing those homeworks, they started becoming pieces, you know, and then we started to develop these pieces and continue to build on that.
I've definitely seen the dancers grow, you know, from auditions to now. They've really grown emotionally and, you know, and just exposing them to that the different style and different culture. It opens up a whole new door for them, you know, as dancers.
Mostly in my life, I feel like sometimes things, they don't last.
I don't know, I guess I used a lot of pain, I guess, that has happened, that I've came across in my life. Like every time I was doing my solo, genuinely, I would think of like all the people who were like, oh, you won't make it dancing, you won't do this. And I was proper expressing that here I am, I'm doing it. Do you know what I mean? I'm doing it, like, and I'm in your face. You can't do anything about it. And do you know what I mean? I'm also leading this riot and whatever. So I don't know, I guess that was my kind of contribution to it.
These homeworks weren't to, you know, expose someone's life or to get into it and say, all right, this is what this, what is your life about? It's more about understanding your feeling and emotion as a dancer. So the more you can be able to bring that out, the more the people in the audience is going to feel you, you know what I'm saying? They're going to feel you. So that it's not fake. You know, it's extremely genuine. And once you get that genuine feeling out to them, they're going to get a genuine feeling back to you. Working with the community firsthand is always great. Because once you get the community involved, people talk, people start to go around, you know, and then they feel more embedded into just wanting to be a part of what you, what I'm saying, what they've helped build. So Tram is one of the supporters of the festival, and they pretty much came up with this idea of just us coming on the trams and just doing some wild stuff and right in Victoria Station. I thought it was a pretty cool idea, and I said, hey, let's do it. There was a lot of like surprise faces, a lot of faces like what are they doing right now? So being with the community is always number one, you know. Hey! 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 Well, the Dream Ring is a dance competition that's in Brooklyn and now in Manchester. And it's a competition that allows you to dance with a partner. And it's always a two-on-twos, tag teams, two-mans, and there's also group routines. And it really, the Dream Ring really strives on the community, a community-based competition pretty much. Really about just building people around you, helping them grow as dancers. And MIF actually, you know, communicating and being with the people, I feel like is a great idea. Because once the guys start to understand the community feel and understand how to work together, the massiveness of where it can go is incredible. Like the guys can start building up their own Dream Ring little events here. Manchester Jack that dances with us, he has this joint called Pilot Nights. Now, the more he brings the community into this, the bigger it's gonna grow. Challenges is something that comes with the territory.
I think we had a moment just like a week before the show or something where things just kind of weren't getting done, and there was a little bit, there was like a gap there.
I think gelling together sometimes was a bit of a, it's a struggle, but we kind of, we worked through it.
Just like any dance company, we've all been through our ups and downs. We've been through our arguments and someone saying this and someone saying that, things like that. But those are regular things, like that happens in everywhere.
Reggie had like a conversation. We all sat down and we all kind of talked about everything that was happening and why people were feeling a certain way about something or had something to say about people, you know, just to let everything out and put it all on the floor. So we did that.
It happens in family. And we've become that, you know what I'm saying, through sharing our experiences with each other, through sharing the flow with each other, sharing tears with each other, blood.
We really got over that, and that was thanks to Reggie, because he's kind of looking at everyone and he's trying to work out what's going on, or if these people, he sees something that's not right, and he would try to fix that. And then after we talked to him, it would be fine.
We went through a lot these past couple of weeks, and it's been an amazing ride, and it did nothing but brought us together and brought us closer. We wanted to be different. You know, we wanted to show that we're not just the regular dancers on here that does what everybody else do. We want to do something different. We want to be not aiming to be popular, but just saying, hey, we want to be something or someone different.
Like, I know a lot of New York guys have, you know, they've been through quite a lot and from the areas that they're from and stuff. And it's just to show that if you can put your mind to something, you know, you can succeed in life.
Every night before we'd go on, we'd have this thing where we kind of just get into a circle and then, you know, say a little prayer and say something like that. And people would say some words just to, you know, give us encouragement. And then, yeah, we just opened that door, and it was like the moment you that door opened, it was kind of like the show is happening.
Like, the best form of meditation for me is just one of those feelings where no matter what's going on, I'm in this world that I'm, everything makes sense.
You never know enough, you know what I mean? There's always something to learn, there's always new styles to learn, there's always new moves to learn, and just be open to any possibilities.
But you gotta get up.
Describe flex in a word. In one word.
One word. Oh, I need like a really good word.
Do you know what? Dream. Yeah.
I want to say magical. I think that's a good word.
Because that's actually 5 words. Dance rules everything around me. Like, that is flexing. That is flexing.
I've learned that flexing isn't pretty. It's aggressive. It's raw. I've learned that, saying, all right, we really don't need too much. All we really need is just ourselves.